Of course, one class of road user who is particularly vulnerable to accidents is the two-wheeler rider. Motorcycles and mopeds are certainly becoming more popular, but is the number of two-wheeler accidents going up at an even faster rate? At the recent Guild of Motoring Writers two-wheel test day, Richard Hudson Evans looked first at the new machines.
Accelerated, no doubt, by the very mild winter, ever-increasing fares, and yet another petrol price increase, in the first quarter of this year, the motorcycle sales have continued to climb, being 10% up on last year. Unlike the car world, new and sporting designs abound. Like this market taster, 50cc, but nonetheless a real motorcycle from the Austrian moped concern Puch. The obsession with economy has not hit the bike makers. Extravagant colours, performance, highly polished components, elaborate engineering such as this new four-cylinder 550 from Honda, an electric start five-speeder for under £900, a new big sister to the very successful 404. While the world leaders are also showing a new automatic transmission model, obviously catering for an increasing and more discerning car-conscious superbike following. Bike of the year makers for several seasons now, Kawasaki providing a £950 alternative form of big bike, the four-stroke Z750, a practical twin aimed at the long-distance tourer and big bike commuter alike. On the British side, since last year, even more a shadow of its former self, at least there's a new moped to tell you about, and high time too. It's the NVT Easy Rider from all that's left of the old, original and still independent Norton Villiers Triumph Empire. Its simplicity itself to ride, the automatic clutch sees to that, and you should get 130 miles in every gallon. What's more, you're unlikely to get booked for speeding, because she'll only do 30 miles an hour flat out. Awkwardly, no fuel gauge, and the tank only takes 3/4 of a gallon, which makes calculating your refill rather difficult. Under the engine, the silencer is vulnerable. Designed in Britain, though, at least, assembled at NVT's last post near Lichfield, but sadly, the components have to be mainly made in Italy, but competitively priced at £145, which on the HP can't be bad. Yet whatever the size of the machine, I suppose the most worrying aspect of motorcycling must be the accident rate. Well, Michael Evans is a spokesman for the industry's Institute of Motorcycling. Now, about the accident rates, they are up, aren't they?
Yes, by about 25% in the third quarter of 1975, but we have to bear in mind the 28% increase in usage, so we have a net decrease, in fact.
I suppose you do also see more and more two-wheelers around on the roads. This has must have some effect on
it. Of course, yes, and of course we're attracting the learner, the new, for the first-time road user, which puts quite a strain on our accident statistics, frankly.
Has the government's appeal for people to wear brighter clothing had any effect, do you think?
I think it has. This sort of clothing is ideal for a motorcyclist. It helps car drivers to see them. It's very difficult to prove, but I'm sure personally that it's been a great
help. What about sports mopeds? A lot of criticism that they're too powerful for the complete learner.
Well, I think this is very much misinformed. The sports moped is capable of about 45 miles an hour. It isn't too fast. And of course, we have the better braking, better handling, which makes the machine an ideal learner's machine.
Unlike the car world, the training schemes are pretty limited, aren't they?
Well, yes, we have the STEP scheme, which is the industry-sponsored schools programme. We spend about £200,000 a year on this. And this is now expanding into the adult training field, and we hope to be able to provide two-wheel teach-ins for all two-wheel buyers within the next year or so.
So some hope in the future?
Definitely, yes.
Michael Evans, thank you.
Thank you.
The industry does provide the finance for the school's traffic education programme, but for riders of all ages, the only available professional tuition is that through the RAC ACU scheme. Harry Louis is a motorcycle journalist and also a member of their committee. Harry, what does the course consist of?
Well, it consists of 24 lessons on average, which extends over about 10 weeks. And this covers theoretical instruction, riding on the road and initially on private land, which is the great merit of the scheme. It's so safe in the first stages.
Do you have to sort of bring along your own machine, or
not
are
necessarily
they provided?
There are machines available, and but if a rider prefers to use his own machine, by all means he may.
How much does it cost?
On average, about £8. It varies from about £4 up to possibly £12. It depends on how much assistance the scheme in the area gets from the local authority.
Are the courses nationwide?
More or less. There are 220 centres, but of course this is not adequate to cover the whole of the country. This scheme has developed over 27 years with, I might mention, amateur, volunteer instructors, ordinary motorcyclists from clubs and so on. And one cannot sort of push this forward with the speed that one would with a purely commercial organisation.
If you had a greater response, like it was made compulsory perhaps by a government, could you cope?
Not at the moment. There would have to be a massive expansion, and this would involve massive injection of cash to do so. And one might say that as part of a road safety campaign, this should be done. At the moment, there is assistance from the government, but I would think the present scheme cost to run may be £50,000. I would visualise that the cost of an absolutely nationwide scheme would be much, much higher.
Harry Louis, thank you.
You're welcome.